After transforming your competent cells with a ligated vector, your next step is often purifying the plasmid from cultured cells. There are many kits available that will help you do this quickly and effectively, but there are also methods for purifying plasmids with common lab reagents. These methods vary, and your lab might have a preferred protocol. Whether using a kit or other method, plasmid purification protocols start from an overnight culture of bacteria and use reagents such as TE buffer, a denaturing solution, a renaturing solution, and ethanol. First, centrifuge the culture to pellet the cells. Remove the supernatant and resuspend the cells in TE buffer. Add a denaturing solution. This will raise the pH and lyse the cells, releasing their contents into solution. Next, add the renaturing solution. This lowers the pH back down, which causes the proteins and genomic DNA to precipitate and leaves the smaller plasmid DNA in suspension. Centrifuge the sample again. This pellet will contain the proteins and genomic DNA, so you'll want to transfer the supernatant, which contains your plasmid in solution, to a new tube. Add ethanol to this tube to precipitate the plasmid DNA and either pellet the DNA by centrifuging again or transfer the sample to a DNA binding column. Wash the pellet or column with 70% ethanol to remove salts and contaminants and elute or resuspend the DNA using water or a neutral buffer such as TE. At this point, your final tube has plasmid DNA in aqueous solution. Depending on your exact method, it might still contain contaminants, such as salts or bacterial proteins that could reduce performance in some assays or applications. You can improve the purity by adding RNase A after lysis or by performing a phenol chloroform extraction. Finally, don't forget to quantitate your DNA before starting your next steps. This video is brought to you by Purified Plasmid Mini Prep System. Up to 15 micrograms of transfection quality DNA in 10 minutes.